It's Joey Mejia. Give him a round of applause, everybody.
Yo, Shanghai, thanks for being here. Thanks for sticking around. Happy Sunday. I was kind of meandering last set, so I'm going to try and be a little tighter. So I will be performing Buck Kegels during this entire set. I'm 5 in already. Okay.
Yeah.
Communication's the topic to start. I recently dropped my cell phone in a parking garage, cracked the screen. I'm one of those reckless people that doesn't have a screen protector. It finally cracked, so I'm kind of fractured and functional, as is my phone right now. But I like how at first the phone technology was like, hey, human, what's your serial number, human? Plug in that number. And then the technology got a little better. It's like, hey, human, where's that finger? Show me what that finger do. Put that in the right spot, human. A little sweaty. Try again, human. I'm often sweaty. And then with facial recognition, which really creeps me out, I don't know about you, but it still creeps me out. I cave, but I do it. Facial recognition, the phone's like, look at me! Joey, look at me better! Look at me like you mean it, Joey! Who are you? You've changed. I don't even recognize you anymore. And I did not need that from my cell phone technology. I get that from my girlfriend. Nah, that's an old joke. I don't have a girlfriend. I don't have a girlfriend that likes eye contact because I live in Seattle. So. Thanks for that extra laugh. Again, communication's important. Like, I did get my degree in journalism. I didn't ever really get an income off of it, but communication is important. So when people say the word library incorrectly, they forget that first R. I think they're just convincing specific men of the world to be dishonest. Like the berries of the world are hearing library, library. And I think that's kind of what messed up Barry Bonds, is all I'm saying. That's a Barry. I don't think he would have had an issue if the world was in town on the lie. Okay. Black celebrity set? Sure. Martin Luther King! Great man, great communicator, that's the theme, right? Martin Luther King, did you know, this is breaking news, one letter away from being a beverage?
Milk.
Milk! Someone got it. Also, I think Martin Luther King set the bar a little too high for dreams. Because I had a dream I was a chameleon. Real childhood dream. I was changing colors like Snake and Metal Gear Solid. Super fun. And then it became a stressful nightmare when an alligator started chasing me, like a stand-up alligator. But I cannot tell my friends, if I had a friend, I could not tell him I had a dream without him expecting civil conversation. So that sentence is ruined forever. Great man, though. I've heard he did great things, so he can pass. Shout out to colorful hair. I saw some colorful hair earlier. I see multicolor hair currently. But I've never dated someone with that beautiful blue hair that you see around Seattle. But if you are in love with someone with that hair color, and that is a devastating breakup, whatever it is, emotional abuse, domestic abuse, whatever your flavor is, and you never see this person again, does that mean you now have a hair trigger for the rest of your life? Gun dad humor, yes. Gun dad jokes. Stupid gun joke, okay. I invited a Bumble date once. I deleted all the apps. It's better for your mental health. Delete them. But I was on a Bumble date once. I invited her to a mic. I went up first. She didn't see my set. Good for her, whatever. But after we were at the date at the bar, we left, she texted me, sorry I missed your presentation. And I thought that was hilarious. Anyway, that's more sad on the dating tip. I'm not going to get into that. I was recently diagnosed by my ex with BPD. Big Puerto Rican dick. I'm toying with douchebag for that one. For those who didn't like that, so I do hate myself, so I am the pastiest Puerto Rican you probably ever laid eyes on. Joey Mejia. Since there was disgusting stuff earlier, let's just say it. A trick to spell my last name, if you can't spell it, must ejaculate juice inside assholes. It's not something... I heard an O. stupid anal sex joke. I have unfounded conspiracy theories, like I believe anal sex cures back pain. No, I've had extreme back pain in my past, too, and I still have it. You would think I would have tested that one, but... Does a finger count? No, I don't... I'm just kidding. Try two fingers. That's a great suggestion. Alright, I'll just mix in some basketball stuff here. Big sports fans? Any sports ball fans around?
Sports!
Nice. Is that a real fist pump there?
Actually, yeah.
Nice. I'm not judging you at all. What sport? What sport's your sport?
Baseball.
Baseball, alright. So Barry Bonds made sense for you. You know who Barry Bonds is?
I was born and raised.
I don't know why I'm talking. Okay. I don't have any more Barry Bonds material. But. Alright, just, I'll leave you on this, stupid one. I'm mad at Kobe Bryant right now, which is a really jarring statement in 2023, I understand. Soon to be 2024, but I'm in therapy, I'm told my feelings are valid, so here we are. I am mad at Kobe Bryant. I'm not mad at the below ground Kobe Bryant. I'd have to be a real asshole to be holding on. Like, I'm a Shaq fan, he's my father figure. But I'd be an asshole to be holding on to that rivalry. I'm mad at a digital Kobe Bryant that exists in my NBA 2K video game. Because I'm an adult boy simulating alternate 90s basketball realities. And Kobe Bryant left me in Orlando. I had Shaquille O'Neal. I had Manute Bol. Penny Hardaway, Dwayne Wade, great team. And he left us for a currency worse than crypto. It's just fake NBA 2K dollars. And also I suck at free throws in that game. So I clank a couple with Kobe. And there's a child actor in the audience that shouts, "He missed them both?" Like, I'm 80% of my backyard. Kobe cannot deliver in this clutch scenario. So Kobe is forever being chastised now with the advent of video games. That is all. I'll leave you. Thank you, Joey. Sorry I went like 40 seconds after this. Jerry Rude.
How could you? That's good bar.
Give it up for Joey!
See how much comedy is Kobe Bryant.
Alright. Alright, on deck we have Craig Stewart, but coming up is Lori Peck.